2019. It is so wonderful to all come together as a community to celebrate the peace, the love, the pilgrim, and the community that we have here. We are so fortunate. Before we get started, I want to thank three people who have been so instrumental in making this all happen. First of all, I want to thank Joanna Stevens, who has helped so very much and has actually shown me how to get up on the stage as well. So Jana, thank you so much for all your work. Mr. Hurley, Steve Hurley, are you here? There he is, awesome. Mr. Hurley, thank you so much for all the work and all the rehearsals that you did with the kids. Always a good thing. And for all the heavy lifting, both metaphorically and physically, that you did to get all of this together. And then finally, I want to thank Chris Williams. Chris Williams, could you please stand? Force in making sure that Kathy Barnum is all that could be. And she was also had a little bit of an illness, but really soldiered through and is here with Joanna's and Steve's help to make sure it all happens. So let's get started. So when we think about community, and we think about gift, and we think about coming together, I am reminded of one of my favorite poets who passed away earlier this year. And her name is Mary Oliver. And the reason I loved Mary Oliver was that she described poetry as a community ritual. And when we all come together as a community, we think about traditions. I think about her. And she wrote, "When you write a poem, you write it for anybody, and you write it for everybody." So I want to share with you, in honor of Mary Oliver, one of her famous poems called Wild Geese. You do not have to be good. You do not have to walk on your knees for 100 miles through the desert repenting. You only have to let the soft animal of your body love what it loves. Tell me about despair, yours, and I will tell you about mine. Meanwhile, the world goes on. Meanwhile, the sun and the clear pebbles of the rain are moving across the landscapes, over the prairies and the deep trees, the mountains and the rivers. Meanwhile, wild geese, high in the clean blue air, are heading home again. Whoever you are, no matter how lonely, the world offers itself to your imagination. It calls to you like the wild geese, harsh and exciting, over and over, announcing your place in the family of things. So with me, we all enjoy the families and things of Cafe Barnum. Thank you.
All the proceeds from tonight will be used to fund the Literary and Arts Department. So thank you so much for coming. And let's give a round of applause. Like
Iku playing Toxic by Britney Spears on acoustic.
Thank you. Our first song is Goodbyes by Georgia Smith. One, two, three.
How could we know that there would be tomorrow? No, but it's where I'm staying. But the bells will ring for you.
From love, wish you were here. Oh, stuck in.
so long separated. Feels it's falling like a riptide this time. Waves crash it fast, I try. Think of the past, please stay. How could it be 20-something, not a lost, not a thing in my name? Ain't got nothing from only no fear. Let's be Miss 20-something. Got nothing running from love. Wish you were here. Oh, stuck in the 20-something. Stuck in the 20-something. Good luck on the 20-something. Good luck.
Thank you.
Latoya. Thank you.
Where does it start? Where does it end? Why does it pour down just to ascend? Why does it try and try and try just to one day say goodbye? What goes up must come down, but why must it bring my face and frown? Don't get me wrong, I don't miss the sun. But why does rain come just to run? Rain helps me sleep, so I don't want to get up. But must I savor my days until I grow up? I'll go to bed just to awake, to do a job that society will make. Stay young, stay fresh, and stay amazing. And don't forget to stay at the rain gazing.
Thank you. Give them all poems. context. There's a picture of my mother when she is in her early 20s, and I saw this picture years ago, and a couple of years ago I wrote this poem inspired by that picture. I remember seeing the picture, and I think we take our parents for granted sometimes, younger ones. All of us, really, the older ones too. And just looking at my mother and how young she was, and I've never seen like her in her youth like that. And it just reminded me of the lives that we don't know that our parents had, this other aspect of them, and made me think about like all of the decisions that they've made in their lives for their children and what they've sacrificed for us. So one other piece of context is my mother has always loved dancing, specifically belly dancing. She doesn't do that by profession, but she's a belly dancer. My mom is, and last thing I'll say, she's an Angeleno, born and raised, but she's been on the East Coast for a while, so I hope she can, you know, I'm channeling her in some way. This is titled The Way She Danced. Thought of a picture of you the other day. Not quite my mind's image of mother, by the way. Model looks, 20 or so. Gaze off to the side, pose for the photo. A woman yet blossoming in the light. Her beautiful brown skin decked in pure white. Dancer's body, hair down to her shoulders. As she then envisioned getting older, what was all the silver that she willed for? Do all her symbols still sing now for more? What could she see that day there in the scope? Arrayed in the glow of youth, could she know, I wonder, the dreams that might go under? In her belly, she too must have hungered for her own life. Yet soon she made us room. Sacrifices seven risen from one womb. Whether toward her heart or duty, the pace with which she followed through was always grace. So with each step, she bore us to the chance to learn to move through life the way she danced. Woo! So this second piece is, it's not really a poem, it's this prose, it's a piece of what we call flash fiction. There was an online challenge that I saw where you had to write a piece in no more than 100 words. So I wrote this piece in exactly 100 words, and I was thinking for a theme, I was at the time thinking about the responsibility of writers, people who work with words and deliver messages, artists. And so I wrote this piece titled Wish of the Wordsmith. The boy and girl watched the hammer at work in their father's hands. When each letter was forged and tempered, he carefully welded them together. Now words, they were dipped in crucibles and later polished for individual allure. Silver words of compassion, reddened words of recrimination, gray words of wisdom, dark words of deceit. Are they for us? The children inquired innocently. Learn them, he simply replied, then drew forth words crude in design, yet beautiful with clear crystal veneer. And those, they asked? These children I wish most for you. Words cut from the truth. Thank you.
I'm looking for love.
Thank you.